Let's do it. I talked myself into it because we have an hour.
So,
you know,
so it'll be what, about an hour?
This is going to be like 10 minutes.
So, trombone. This is a trombone case.
So, what is a trombone?
I'm going to teach you how to assemble it, but kind of part zero is how to open the case properly. First of all, I just didn't, like, I broke step one, which is don't open it on a desk or anything elevated.
Why did you do that?
Well, I didn't open it yet, but, like, the reason why is, you know, you can open it and not realize, and it just...
First things first, what's a trombone?
So, a trombone is a brass instrument that is cylindrical, so it's bright sounding and loud and fun.
So I think we should move the camera.
So, the latches open up this way. So, oh my god.
Jeez.
So, as long as you're opening them up like this, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
If you open up the other way, it will be upside down and then your instrument will fall out. So, this is the right way. Also, usually the logo's on top.
Alright.
Anyways, and then you can open the thing. The handle usually stays on the bottom, so. Also, yes, it's slippery. And the trombone case is kind of like the worst case.
The worst case scenario.
No, it is just the worst case. So, you're gonna, it depends, all cases are different. Sometimes the slides go in here, so this is more, you'll figure that out.
Right.
So, generally, I want you to grab the slide first, and then you'll grab the bell.
All right.
So, we can assemble it up here, actually. So, yeah, just grab the slide.
The rules.
No, just you just can't open the...
Okay.
And when you assemble it, you can hold it, actually. And then I'll grab this for you.
Right?
And then throw that into the pit of fire.
Goodbye forever.
You're gonna grab this and put it onto here, the longer one. Yep, and then once it's fully set down, you can start tightening that, but not all the way, you know. You're gonna bend this until it's about 90 degrees, and you're gonna know if it's the wrong side.
All right.
This is the right side, but basically you want the slide on the right side of the bell,
mm-hmm.
because that's, you kind of just play it right-handed, you can't play it left-handed.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you tighten this all the way. And now you can pick up the whole thing. Fun.
We've done it.
Yep. And I'm playing, so now to hold it, yeah, that's actually the hardest part. How do I want to teach this? Finger gun.
Finger guns.
You're going to put all, you're going to put all your fingers in between the square
mm-hmm.
and your thumb on top of this brace.
All right. So.
Yep. And then your pointer, yeah, just rests right there because eventually... You're gonna put your mouthpiece there, and you just lightly twist it in.
Okay.
You don't do this. I'll tell you what happens when you do this. It's really fun.
Does it get stuck?
It does get stuck. But this is the fundamental pitch, or like, the main pitch that this instrument makes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to do it too hard, because it will actually get stuck.
Yeah.
Yep, so you can just practice holding that. I only put my pinky down here occasionally, is because if this, slide lock is open, that will happen.
So
but
the
like,
pinky just kind of also holds it in?
Yeah, but when you're actually playing, you're going to let go, and your right hand, just lightly pinch like this, it's just going to hold like there. Yep. And there's not really a correct way, as long as it's like relaxed and not, and then...
Hold it like an Italian.
Yep. Yeah, like an Italian. I don't know if I should be. Yeah, and then you can feel how it feels to move it now.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. Now I'm going to bring it back and lock it, but you're going to, for like actual playing position, this can be more angled, by the way. If it's too flat, what happens is it just kind of feels like it's falling off.
Mm.
And if it's too angled, well, two things. It might be easier to hold because that's how gravity works, I guess, in physics. But if it's too angled, then it kind of feels like this.
It's going to hit you in the head.
That, and also when you do end up playing. So,
right,
you know, somewhere like
seems unpleasant.
It's like 90 degrees minus a little.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna expect you to know all of this. No, just
good.
And then as for playing position, like with most instruments, you're always gonna stand up straight, like shoulder width apart. So that way you can breathe from your belly instead of your shoulder. So not this. It's like, you're like breathing opposite. You wanna breathe from the bottom up, so that way you get more air.
Okay.
Right? And, I don't know, just bring this all the way 90 degrees out. I did not tighten this up. And you're bringing the instrument to your face or your mouth, not your face to here. Because if you do, then you're like...
Yeah.
And eventually, you want to try to keep this as still as possible. Because if you're doing this and moving the mouthpiece, that's going to make it harder for you to... Well, no, it makes it harder for you to like keep a consistent tone.
Mm.
You want the mouthpiece... Wow, I am... language. My speaking. You want the mouthpiece to be like in the same spot all the time. It just makes it easier.
Mm-hmm.
So that's playing position. You can actually hold up for a bit while I bother you more with this. Pointer on the...
Yep.
Yep. You can come face towards the camera.
Yay. What a beautiful hold.
I know. What? This is like the worst vlog documentary.
Yeah, I know, right?
Okay. Cool. I forgot my lesson notes. Playing position. Okay. We're gonna take a break now. So you can just like place it down. As for placing stuff, you kind of just... You generally want it to be like a triangle.
Mm-hmm.
You can place it the other way, it's fine. It's just like a... Well.
More stable.
Yeah, it just rocks. It's like, it's fine.
Yeah.
But... Also, it shouldn't be putting on top of a bench, but I'm lazy. Okay, so this is your mouthpiece for the day. I cleaned it.
Sweet.
And it still smells bad. Oh well. Buzzing. That's like the main way you make the sound. So there's kind of two schools of thought that you're not buzzing. In the sense that if I'm buzzing... Right?
Mm-hmm.
Versus like...
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's easier to think about buzzing, like actually buzzing your lips together. Like, keep them somewhat separated, and then just buzz your lips, and then this just kind of focuses the buzz. So like, actually,
okay.
You can try. Any sound. Keep it sustained. Okay. Can I hear by yourself? That's actually pretty good. Okay,
we're gonna match to this pitch.
Oh wait, actually. Go ahead. How about try this pitch? Make an M and relax your lips. Like, maybe more gap. Less air, like blow slower. I think that was a little too much because now you're hitting this one, which is good. Actually, if that feels comfortable. That's good. We just want you to like hit one pitch.
Uh-huh.
So what happens is when you eventually pick this up, you're going to like, this amplifies that buzz.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
You can try. Yep. You got the light twist instead of the bob. That's good.
We got
good.
The, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, hold on.
That's pretty good. There, by the way, there is no, like, unlike with violin, which I taught.
Yeah.
There isn't, like, the hole where you need to have it, like, perfectly arched to keep your, like, repetitive stress injury stuff. This is, like, hold on and make sure it's stable.
Hold on for dear life.
The idea is, like, if you do have this, then you have to be, like, very particular.
Mm-hmm.
If you're just clamping down, like, the way you are, as closest to the skin, then you can actually control the instrument with your arm, and you don't have to, like, work over time.
Okay.
Because this is heavier than a, you know, violin. And then you bring it up to, and do that same buzz. You're gonna... Take your breath. That's actually good. You're just running out of air. That's why you're getting sharper. Right? Mm-hmm. Deeper breath. Do it again. Are you lightly putting the mouthpiece against your lips? Because you can put it with more pressure. Not like, don't jam it onto your lips, but you can... Yeah. Okay. This is gonna be hard. Take the mouthpiece off again.
Alright.
This is step two, so we could save this for another day, but I want to see if you can.
How much time are
we? Okay, we're fine. Can you slide up to here? So, with the mouthpiece, actually. Just buzzing.
Okay.
So, start with this pitch that you, like, got. Open the mouth a little. Like, not too... You actually hit this first try. So if you want, you can go back to here and try to loosen so you get to B flat.
Not sounding good.
Honestly, you like most students, you end up practicing this like for a week.
Mm-hmm.
So you made more progress than you think.
Okay.
Yeah, than you thought. Than I thought.
I didn't think
my
I'd make
English.
Any progress. I didn't think I'd make any progress, but here we are.
No, that's good.
I can play trombone.
Yeah, let's just try to sustain one pitch. So just make a buzz again. Try to bring it up. So whether that be like tighter corner of your lips or bring your lips together to make a faster air. Just keep trying. That's it, yeah. And then the whole idea is now you just practice keeping that pitch over and over again until you get used to the idea that how buzzing works and feels. Tight corner. Your chin's actually fine, but also you don't want your chin to, like, move with each, like... Because then you're adding extra air or something, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But, no, I think that was good.
Sweet.
Yeah.